Hello, this is Victor. I'm here continuing the work on the hellions, and now I will show how to paint these types of gems here, and also these small ones on the side. And instead of using this one, that is going to be more difficult to show the effect, I will paint on this one that I don't have anything on front. So first, I will apply a layer of Caliban green, so any dark green will work for that, and I apply this all over the gem. And that one, and I will do the two big ones. And then I will do, as example, these two small. I have to assume that in the other cases will be the same. Just to save video time. Then, I will apply black. This case is going to be Abaddon black. Keep this pink here. In one side of the gem, like that. It's like taking the top of the gem, for example, and doing like a semicircle. On the small ones, we will do the same. I will apply Abaddon black just like that and like that. So what I try to do is to put the reflection in all the gems in the same direction. So the point that is like if there is a focus of light is from the same side for all the gems. Then I will take Warpstone Glow . I will apply a layer quite dilute on the opposite side of the black. So something like that, and then we'll apply the same on the small ones, something that is like that, so this is how it's looking like, and I will go, then I will use Putrid Green. I will just put the green we'll do just a line like that. Just do a small line. Like that. Then on the small gems, I just put a point on like that. You like that. And to finalize, I will take white. Okay. Take the white, and in the case of the big gem, I will do like two light spots. So you can do something like that. Then a small one here. And I will do the same for this one. One big. Okay, in that case, the spot is not well done. So I will show how to correct, and then one other here. And on the small ones, just a small spot on the opposite side of the wheel. So, and that is how you should do a good effect on the gems. Now here that I don't like the spot, we will go back to the black and try if this is happening. Just try to make the spot so, no. So and this is a good way to do the gems. You can also do blending to make the transitions softer, but I think in the gems is working quite well to have these hard transitions. So that's all for the gems. So I will try to do now the videos more focused on the specific techniques and on the specific areas. So this is how I will do the gems in all of my scale riders. Here you see another example. Also you see here the small ones green. When it's too small, like these ones, I don't do I only put the part of the green, but I can, there's not a space for the white dot. So that's all for that video. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you again later. Bye!